Hello and welcome to Web Applications for Everybody. Today we're going to learn a little bit about NGROK. NGROK is a way that we can get our assignments autograded, and perhaps you are in the lesson where we're doing this grading of the guessing game, right? We're grading the guessing game. And we have to put some code here. And the problem here is that we have to have this code running on our laptop or our, because this server is on the real internet and it can't talk to your laptop. And so what I've got is I've got some code running here, and it's in my applications mamp htdocs assn subguess subbroken.php. And so I'm running mamp, so that code right there is the same as what I'm seeing here. And so if I type guess, you know, I can say guess equals 42. Well, or I get missing guess parameter, and our guess equals 42. Yay, I'm right. Okay, so the problem is if I just take this URL and I put it in the guessing game, I mean, if I put it in the autograder, this autograder is running out there in the internet somewhere, and it can't connect to localhost because your localhost is not also on the internet. So we have to find a way. So this is going to blow up really badly, and this shows you something about the test. When things blow up, sort of look from the bottom up and look for toggle. And this, it looks icky. You have to read it. This looks like it might be like a bug, but it's not. It is a, it can't connect to port 80.80.88. Connection refused, this URL. So don't just assume that the autograder is blown up. Sometimes the autograder like gets an error and it shows you what it is and it tried to retrieve your file and it couldn't. So, you know, something went wrong, okay? So that's the problem. We've got to get to the point where this, we can't use this localhost URL. But as I've said, there is this wonderful piece of software called NGROK. And what NGROK does basically is makes it so that anyone on the real internet can talk to your laptop. So over here is where the server is. This is where your MAMP is. This is you and your, right? So you're running MAMP over here. Right, MAMP over there, and this is the autograder right here. The autograder cannot talk to your localhost. It can't do that. That doesn't work. But you can run a piece of software that effectively exports your localhost to this place called ngrok.com, and then the autograder can talk to that. And I'm going to show you how to do that. Now, to get this to work, you've got to download some software. So let's do that. Let's go to download. Now it's different from Mac and different from Windows, so I'm going to download it. And it's a pretty small piece of code. And I'm going to put this in, it's going to be in my downloads folder. Where's the downloads folder? There's the downloads folder. And it's a zip file. There might be different install processes for Windows, but you'll get to the point where you have this NGROK running. Okay, so. So we have this running on localhost and we've downloaded NGROK. So what I've got to do is I've got to start a terminal window or command prompt if you're on Windows. And I have to get myself in that terminal window. I have got to go into that downloads folder. And in Macintosh, it's user downloads, and I do an ls minus l, and I can see that this NGROK is here. And this was the zip file. And I can start it by saying ./ngrok. It's important that I don't have to run ngrok in the same as where my code's at. Because ngrok is basically forwarding port 80.80.88, 4/8, to the web. So I'm just going to say ./ngrok, HTTP, we're going to fake the HTTP protocol, and localhost, the 8888 port on this localhost. And if all goes well, ngrok is going to wake up, and then it's going to tell you an address. Now, the key to this is that this address is only going to work while this ngrok program is running. A program is running now and forwarding all these connections. So the thing to do, and you'll get a different one of these every time. And so if I go here and I go to ngrok.io, you will see exactly what happens if you go to localhost 8088. See? All that stuff. And my assignments are sitting here in assignments. I can go to assignments, and I can go into the guest folder, and now I'm here. Except this URL is a real URL. This is a URL that can run anywhere on the internet. This URL can only run on a browser that's running on my computer sitting at my local host. So now I can use this, guest.php, and I can turn this into the Autograder. So I got to go back and I got to launch the Autograder and give it this URL. So now I'm going to say run this. This is a real URL anywhere on the internet, including where this Autograder is running from, because this Autograder is really running somewhere on the internet. So what happens is when I hit evaluate, we'll go back to when I hit evaluate, this is going to connect to NGROK, and NGROK is going to send data to your computer, and the request response cycle is going to come back. Now, interestingly, if you watch, you can see this happen here. And so you've seen I've already done some GET requests, and there's actually a little monitor guy that I can put up over here, 127.0, that's another word for localhost. And this is actually allows me to inspect the data that's going back and forth here. So my Autograder talks to NGROK, NGROK talks to your computer in a reverse way, and you're watching this data that's going back and forth, and that's what's going on here and here. Okay, so both of these are talking. So I'll just leave this, let's make this a little more narrow now so you can kind of, let's put this maybe way over here so you can see it. Oops, made it too small. No, it's not looking good. Okay. Okay, we'll watch it over here. So now I am back where I'm going to do my evaluation. You can watch action happening over here. Now, one of the things about this assignment, depending on who you are, it gives you a different number. And so that's why you've got to change this code. So I'm supposed to make 37 be my correct answer to get full credit. So I'm going to evaluate it. And you can see it's talking. See, it went talking. Didn't find Chuck Severance in the title tag. Guess is too high. Now, the key is you're like, oh, what's wrong? Look at the toggle. Okay. So it's like, did not find Chuck Severance in the title tag. Well, oh, that's because it's Charles Severance. Okay. Looking for your guess is too high. It says your guess is too low. You see, it's always trying to tell you as much as it can. I'm not trying to make this tricky. Okay. And so the problem here is this code that I've got, that's guess code, has got 42 is the right answer. So I can fix my program by making 37 be the right answer. 37, save. Now I can rerun the test and I should pass that stuff. And these errors went away, but Chuck Severance is still not in the title tag, so I changed that. Chuck Severance. And I rerun the test. And I got passed. Okay, so there we go. Everything is good. I don't know what that internal error is. That's probably because I'm an instructor. Yeah, but so there you go. So that's the basic idea of how you run NGROK. And the way you finish this when you're all done with this is you just hit Control C. So remember this, AFA 30 something. Okay, so I'm gonna hit Control C. And now this URL ceases to work. All right, this one will blow up because I'm not there on the other side. So it doesn't find it. If I run NGROK again, I start the tunnel back up, but you will notice I will get a different number, 5EB something. So this address no longer works, but this one does. So you can start and stop NGROK as many times as you want, but you sort of have to realize that every time you start and stop it, you're going to get a new address. Now you can actually pay money to them to get more permanent addresses, et cetera, et cetera. But as long as you know how to switch back and forth and get the right address, it should not be difficult whatsoever. Okay? And so there we go. I hope this has helped you understand how to use NGROK so that you can do the send your assignments from your laptop web server all the way to the Autograder on the internet.